is UR limb. After I explained to you people what is the meaning of UR limb, I said that it is a library for requesting documents from the server. This is much simpler than the socket programming. In the socket programming, you know that you have to open the socket and all that. Here, you just need to know what is the URL of that, and then you will be able to access that information. So we saw how to request data using URL lib. And then we saw yesterday how to read binary files. Binary files means any file that is an image or an audio, video, anything for that matter is a binary file. We can either save it in the form of binary as JPEG, okay, and how to read that as a binary, we saw that. And this was a simple example yesterday. We wrote 4 lines of code only to download an image. And then we saw how to download the entire image and save it at once. And then we saw how to download the image and store it block by block. Okay, 1 lakh bytes at a time we can store it to the data image, and then we can store it to the river. So that also we saw block by block how to download it. And then I told you people yesterday that we will be doing something called as web scraping. Web scraping is a very important concept. Web scraping is a concept in which we people use it nowadays for accessing information from the internet. How is data? First, let me tell you what is the web. In very simple terms, web or the internet is the biggest network. And then on this network, there are servers, there are clients. Servers are those which contains documents, which contains data. And then these documents are then requested by the clients, and the clients are sent. The servers will send these response, these documents to the clients, and the clients receive this. Okay, so this is called as the internet. This is how the internet actually works. A lot of data is there on the servers. You have a lot of documents. Documents, when I say document, it is not only text documents. It is image files. It is video files. It is audio files. A lot of documents are there. And then you can request this if it is there on the server, and then the server will give it back to you, which you have to receive it. Now, the pages that we request on the internet, for example, let us say I request a page. Okay, let us say I go to Google and then I say what is IoT. If I say what is IoT, then it will give me a lot of details here. It will go and show me a lot of pages which contains this information. Now, how is this data given to me? For example, if I click on this link here, it will go to a particular website, and then it will give me all the details here. So you can see what is IoT, everything you need to know about Internet of Things and so on. So this is the document which is coming to me from the server. I requested this document by putting a address here in the URL bar. I put the address here, I clicked on the link, and then I requested this page, and that's the reason why this page was given back to me. And then this page contains a lot of things. It contains images, it contains some video, it contains text data. A lot of things are there. Some images are there. A lot of things. Advertisements are there. So many things are there in this document. Now, web scraping. I will tell you what is the meaning of web scraping now. You understand what is the meaning of a web document. A document which is kept on the server, which you are able to request. And this document is given back to you is called as a web document. And this document can contain audios. It contains videos. It contains images. If there is text in this web page, and if you want to retrieve, let us say, for example, this is your entire web page. In this web page, let us say you are interested to remove only selected data. For example, you want to remove only the definition of what is the internet. Only this much. I am interested only in this particular. I am not interested in all these other things. I'm not interested in these advertisements, these images, these videos. No, I'm interested only in the definition, only this part I'm interested in. So accessing this entire document in your Python file, you know how to do it using URL lib. You can request the entire HTML page, and it can come into a variable in your Python file. And then in that entire data, this data is also there. The definition of what is internet from here to here is also there. Now, extracting only that part whichever you are interested in from the web document is called as web scraping. Now that you have understood what's meaning of web scraping, Now let us see how to do it in using Python. Now some people will ask me, sir, why it is required, why do we require web scraping? Web scraping is required because let us say there is a website which contains some important information. Okay, and apart from this important information, there are other things also on the website which I don't want. I want to exactly retrieve only that particular thing only. So to, and there are many applications which will require that you need to access only selected data from this web document and not the other data. Lot of applications are there. I can give you numerous examples where this type of application is required. Okay, so there web scraping is important. It is applicable. It is important. Web documents contain a lot of data, lot of advertisements, images, but I am interested only selected part of the document to extract this only, neglecting or neglecting other part of the document is called as web scraping. Now let us see how to do this. Parsing, let us see the definition of this parsing first. Parsing HTML, remember all these documents which come from the internet, these all documents are HTML documents. All these documents are HTML documents, remember that. So parsing HTML and scraping the web. One of the common use of URL link capability in Python is to scrape the web. It's to scrape the web. Web scraping is when we write a program that pretends to be a web browser and retrieves pages. We have to write a Python program which will request a page from the server. So when some software is requesting a page from the server, it is doing a job of a browser. So we have to pretend that we are a browser. So it retrieves pages from the server and then it examines the data in those pages looking for patterns. It looks for a particular pattern. It looks for a particular pattern because I want to retrieve only selected data from there. So I look for a particular pattern and I retrieve only that part of the data from the document. For example, a search engine such as Google will look for at the source of the one page and extract the links to other pages and retrieve those pages, extracting links and so on. Okay. Now, what does this Google search engine does? It retrieves a particular page and in that page, in that HTML code, it will look for only links, hyperlinks. Links are those which you can click and go to the next page. These are called as links. So Google search engines will retrieve a page. In that page, it will look for links and then go to the other pages like that it does. This is how Google actually works. But we are not interested in Google right now. What you should know right now is that what is the meaning of web scraping, how it is done. So in simple terms, let me tell you that web scraping is a technology, it's a technique where you request a page from the server and in that page, you search for a particular pattern and data that only you require. You don't use the other part of the document. You use only that part of the document which you are interested in. This is called as web scraping. Extracting information that is important to us, neglecting the remaining data. This is web scraping. Okay. This is web data. And then after that, let us see how to do that. We can do that using Python, of course, and by using Python with regular expressions. You know what is the meaning of a regular expression? Regular expressions, we have done this in one of the modules previously. It's a concept where you can retrieve data from a big text which matches a particular pattern. If it matches a particular pattern, then you can retrieve it. And that pattern matching is done using regular expressions in Python. Okay. Now let us say whenever you write an HTML page, okay, let me tell you that whenever, I don't know whether how many of you know HTML, but you will be learning this in the next semester in programming the web subject. But let me tell you that whenever we write HTML documents, you know, it always starts with a tag that is HTML, then followed by the body tag, then followed by the content of the HTML document. It can contain data like welcome to NMEC, that text can be there inside it and all that. And in the web page, if you want a link or to go to the next page, then the link is put into the web page by writing this particular tag. It is called as the ahref tag. Ahref. This tag is very, very important. When you write this particular tag in the HTML document, it causes a link to come in your web page. It always starts with this ahref is equals to. Then you write down the URL of the page to which you want to navigate to. You close the tag. You write the link how it should appear and then you close the A tag. You start with the A tag, you write ahref, write the document, address of the document to which you want to navigate to, close the tag, write down how the link should appear. It should appear like second page, it should be underlined. So when you go on that second line and you click on that, it will take you to the next page. And then you have slash A. So this is the entire anchor tag. It is called as the anchor tag or the hyperlink tag or the link tag, whatever you want to call it as, it is called as that. This causes a link to appear on your HTML document. Okay, so this is the URL to which it will navigate to. This is the text that will be displayed in the link. This is what will happen. Now, I want to do one thing. I want to request a web page from the server, and I want to search. I want to search in that page all the links which are present. That's the reason why I first introduced you to what is the meaning of a link, a hyperlink in a document. How will it look like? It will always look like this. If in a HTML document there is a link, it will always start with the A tag, a href tag like this. Now what I want to do is I want to request a HTML page from the server, and in that page I want to count or I want to retrieve all the links. I want to retrieve all the links in that page. And you know how the links will look like. It will always start with a href, some address will be there, then slash a will be there. So this is how it will look like. Now that you know how will a link tag look like, other tags also you should know. H1 tag is also there in HTML, which will display whatever is in between this H1 tag will be displayed big and bold in HTML. Okay, then you have the P tag, which actually represents a paragraph. A tag, you already know, A tag is used for anchor or hyperlink or link. They use it for that. So these are the only tags which are introduced here, and this is sufficient for you people. So what we are planning to do now, we are planning to write a Python program to retrieve a complete web page from the server. And in that page, we are planning to count, or we are planning to retrieve only the links. How many links are there in this page? We want to retrieve that. Now let us write a program for that. First of all, if I want to check for a hyperlink, if I want to check for a hyperlink, what is the regular expression that I write? I write it like this. Let us say the name of my pattern is href is equal to double quote, I write. My pattern should start with HTTP because in any hyperlink, remember HTTP is definitely required. So I'm checking for HTTP colon two slashes dot, dot should be there. This is my pattern for checking a hyperlink in a HTML page. So I have HTTP colon two slashes dot, dot, what does dot represent in a pattern? Anything, dot matches anything. It can be a digit, it can be a white space, it can be an alphabet, it can matches anything. Plus is there. What does plus means here? Plus means that this dot should appear at least once, or more also is fine. Or more also is fine. Okay. And then after that, there's a question mark here. You can see the question mark here indicates that the map should find smallest possible matching string. The question mark at the end of the pattern represents that it should match the smallest possible matching string. So don't worry much about that right now. Just think that if I want to match a link in my HTML document, then I have to write this pattern. It should start with HTTP colon two slashes dot one or many, no problem. Now consider the Python program. Now this is the program that I want to write. So this is my program. Very simple program it is. Okay, it's a very simple program. What is the program for? The program is for doing web scraping. What is web scraping? Web scraping is a technique of requesting a web page from the server and retrieving, extracting only that part which I am interested in. So I am planning now to request a web page from the server, and in that web page, I am searching how many links are there. How many links are there, and I want to display these links to the user. This is the program that I am writing. So how to write this program? It is given here. First of all, import urllib request, import re. Why do we import re? We import re for regular expressions, you know that. Then url, we are reading it. When I say input means it will read it from the user. So it will read the URL from the user, and then after that it will request this URL from, it will request, what I will do is I'll simply copy this program. Yeah, that's it. Only that much is the program. So I'll say file new and paste it. Yeah, this will not come proper first. I will write them properly first. Yeah. modulus 5. Call this as webscript.py. Webscript.py. This is how I save the program. So you can see what is there in the program. Very little. First of all, I import URL lib. In that, from that, I request this class request. Then I imported regular expressions. Then I am reading. I did not mention the URL directly here because I want to read it from the user. So that's why I write URL is equals to input enter. I ask enter the URL. So the URL will be entered from the command prompt. Remember, I'm not giving it directly here. Then after that, URL is entered by the user that is requested by using urllib.request.url open. You know how to request this using urllib. So you pass the URL that is entered by the user, and whatever information is coming from there, read it and put it into the variable HTML. Okay. And then in HTML, check for this pattern. I use regular expression dot find all. Find all a href http, search for this pattern. Where to search it? Search it in HTML. And what is HTML? HTML is a document that you have requested from the server, which has come from the server. So in HTML, check for this pattern using regular expression and using the method called as find all. Regular expression dot find all this pattern in this data. So what will this find all function give you back? It will give you a list. So that list I'm displaying it here. For link in links, links is the list. So for link in links, for x in list, you can do that. No, each item it will take at a time. So for link in links, print link.decode. So you keep printing it to the user. So it will display you all the ahrefs which are there in the document. Okay, simple program. So I have saved it here. I will run the program and I'll show you. I'll go to the command prompt, and then here. And then I will run the program Python. What was that? Webscript.py. Enter. So now see, it is asking me, enter the URL. It is asking me, please enter the URL of the page that you want to download. And in that page, you want to check how many links are there. So you enter the URL of that page, it is telling me. Because why it is asking me? Because I've written here input enter. So it is waiting for me to enter something, and then whatever I enter will be put into URL that will be requested and click come back. Okay. So before I enter the URL here, I will do one thing. I will go here. What I will do is, see, there are so many. Look at this page only. See, there is a link here, there's a link here. See, all these are links. Okay. Even this is a link. Then this is a link. So many links are there. So I will copy this URL only. I'll copy this URL. And then that URL, I will paste it here. See, I pasted that URL there because I don't remember any URL which has got links and all that. So what I did was I went to the internet, browsed to some page, and that page's URL I took, and then I pasted that here. And let me press on enter. So the moment I press on enter, first your program will go to the internet, fetch this page entirely, and then it is taking time. It is taking time because it has to go to the, now see, it displayed me all the links here. See how many links are there. So many links are there. There's a link, znet.com, so many links. So it displayed me all the links. So the program, what it is doing, it is requesting the page, checking for HTTP. Wherever HTTP is present, please check for that, it is saying, and then it is displaying it. You can see that. See how many links are there. So it displayed me all the links. So if I go to some other page, let us say I go to, now I have I have my website, okay. I have my own web space. If I say myspace.welcomeonline.com, see, this is my web page actually. There's nothing much, no links are there, absolutely no links are there. So if I copy this URL, copy, and if I run this project, if I run this file, web scrape, and it is asking me for the URL. Now I will enter this URL, myspace.welcomeonline.com. This is my website. I'm just taking a little time to go. Absolutely, it is not displaying any link here because this page doesn't contain any link. this page does not contain any link. So that's why the document which came back from the server, it does not contain any link, so it did not display anything. It is empty. It is empty you saw. But at the same time, if I paste this previous, for example, if I will go to some other link right now, okay, so I'll go to google.com, let us say, we'll put google.com. So here there are very few links. There is one link here, there's one link here, some links over here. So I'll copy google.com, copy this, and I will paste, okay, www.google.com, enter. So now, see, there are two links are there, One to go to English, Hindi, all that. I think it is this thing to change the language, all that. And the other link is over there. So it displayed me the links which are there on this particular page. I hope you understood what is this. Web scraping, very important from examination's point of view. What did we do? I will very briefly explain to you once again. We have learned the concept of web scraping. First of all, what is web scraping? Web scraping is a technique which will request a HTML page from the server, HTML page, which is also called as a web page, from the server, and then it will go through the entire web document, web page, HTML page, and then search for a particular pattern, and it will retrieve that information and display it to us. So web scraping is a technique where we extract information which we are interested in only, ignoring, neglecting the other part of the document. We wrote a program now in Python to request a web page, and from that web page we extracted only the links. Okay, now one more thing I will show you in the same example. If you want to place an image, on a web page, you use this tag. Like, for example, I told you to put a paragraph, we use the p tag. To put a hyperlink link, we use a a tag. To put a text in a big font, we use h1 tag. So similarly, if I want to put an image on a web page, we use the img tag. Now I want to check that. I want to check how many images are there. Instead of this, I will comment that. Instead of finding this, I want to search for img tag. I just changed href. I don't want to search for hyperlinks. I don't want to search for links. I want to search for how many images are there. In that web page, I want to check. So I put img tag. Save the program. File save. Okay. So I go to the program. I executed it. Python web scrape. And then I will paste google.com. Enter. Let us see. See, there are so many places where this img tag is present. Now, hang on, it is coming very big. So shortest, no, so I'll put a question mark. So it displayed me only one place. That it is appearing. And first time it displayed me the entire tag. It contains a lot of things inside it, but I did not want it everything to come. So I just displayed by putting question mark there. And see, it displayed me that there is only one place in the entire document. Where the image is appearing. And I think it is this image. Okay, which is coming over there. Now let us go to some other website. Here, if I go, if I put this as a URL, pull this image and check how many images are there, it will give me zero. So if I paste myspace.belgaumonline.com, so you can see that, see, it displayed me nothing, zero, because on this page there is no image only. Similarly, if I go to some other web page, let us say I go to what is IoT. If I go to what is IoT and then if I click on the same link, okay, I have copied this. Copy this link and go here. And sorry, I have to run the program. I'll clear the screen first. I will clear the screen. I will clear the screen, and then after that, I will run the program. I will paste my URL. Enter. Now it will go fetch the data and then check for how many images are there, and then it should display me. See how many images are there in this page. It will display me 1, 2, 3, 4. So I can count and I can tell you how many images are there. So you can go to this and see. Of course, you can see so many images here. One is over here. The other one is over here. This is one other image. See, so many images are there on this page. So it displays me here all the images which are there in that page. So finally, I hope you understood what is the meaning of this. What we did today is we understood what is the meaning of web scraping. Web scraping is a technique of retrieving information that we are interested in. Okay, and we wrote a program to retrieve first hyperlinks, and then I showed you one example to retrieve images. I showed you one example to retrieve images from the website. Okay, so like that we can write any retrieving any type of a data from a web page, and then we can do useful things with it. Right now we are only displaying it to the user, but you can use this information if you are really interested in web scraping. Then you know, and I told you that it is very useful. It is very very useful. Right now you may be thinking that it is only a concept that will retrieve only selected data, but for the latest applications which are required, this is very important. Web scraping is very important. You can write very very useful applications using web scraping. Yeah, maybe I may not be able to give you a very good example right now, but remember that web scraping is a very very useful tool. You have to write programs like this only: retrieve a web page, use a pattern, search for that pattern, and retrieve selected data from the web page. Okay, so these programs are there with me. If you have any doubts, please ask me, because this is what I just want to explain to you people. There are only 8 minutes. We still have enough time. 8 minutes are there. Meanwhile, you know, you can discuss with us if there are any problems or that. You can please discuss me about this topic which we discussed today. You can ask me any questions apart from this, from this subject only. If you have doubts in some other part, you can please ask me that. Okay, or any other thing that you want to discuss with me, please discuss. No problem. Okay, we have enough time. You can unmute yourself and please discuss anything you want to ask. Please ask me. I will stop sharing the screen. Yeah, there are 13 participants. Yeah, I saw your chat on the official group that you were asking sir to give you more time for the quiz and all that. Don't worry much about. First, I will stop.